Watch this video till the end without skipping to know all the important dermatology related must know points for FMGE examination. Hello dear students, myself Dr. Maddineni Srinivas. Welcome to Crack Derma with DrMSD. Let us begin our discussion with the most important topic, which is a papulosquamous disorder, psoriasis, which will clinically present with silvery white scaly plaques present over the extensor surfaces. And if you observe, there are two important terms here. One is Auspitz and the other one is Koebner's phenomenon. Remember, whenever there is scaly lesion, we take a glass slide, we will scrape the scaling, which is called as grattage, and we are going to get a bulkless membrane, which is a white membrane. If you remove that membrane, we are going to ultimately get the pinpoint bleeding spots, which is the end point of the Auspitz sign, which is the end point of Auspitz sign, and it is positive in the patients of chronic plaque psoriasis, which is also called as psoriasis vulgaris. Remember, Auspitz sign could be negative in three types of psoriasis: pustular psoriasis, inverse psoriasis, and guttate psoriasis. The other named phenomenon, which is called as Koebner's isomorphic phenomenon, it is positive in psoriasis. It is also seen in lichen planus and also vitiligo. What does this mean? When we give a trauma over the normal looking skin, because of the underlying autoimmunity, there will be new lesions produced due to the underlying autoimmunity. This is what is called as Koebner's isomorphic phenomenon. So like, share, subscribe to my YouTube channel and comment winner if you want to be a successful student in this upcoming FMG examination. Next is the erythrasma. This was UPSC exam recently asked. Causative organism is corneal vector minutism. Diagnosis is made with the help of Wood's lamp, which will show coral red fluorescence. Remember, in the Wood's lamp, Petrosis versicolor is going to give a yellow fluorescence. Next is Petrosis versicolor. So remember, KVOH is going to show a presence of the spaghetti meatball, which are the combination of the hyphae and the spores on the KVOH mount, and the causative organism is Malassezia globosa more than Malassezia furfur. Treatment, we are going to use topical azoles and also terbinafine, and orally itraconazole can be used in P. versicolor. And deep fungal infection, mycetoma, chromoblastomycosis, sporotrichosis, all of them are very important. Sporotrichosis, history of rose thorn prick followed by the development of nodular ulcerative lesions in a linear fashion following the lymphatics is going to be given. Very important image based question. So if the examiner wants you to think of mycetoma, they are going to give three features: granule sinuses and tumefaction or tumor like swelling. Then you should think of mycetoma, and if the granules are dark granules, think of eumycetoma. If they are pale granules, think of actinomycetoma. If followed by rose thorn prick, there is development of a verrucous lesion, then think of verrucous dermatitis, which is chromoblastomycosis. The examiner will also give clues that copper penny bodies, medullar bodies, muriform bodies are seen. These are all the clues which will be given in the chromoblastomycosis. Basal cell carcinoma, remember, it does not have any pre-malignant stage, and clinically it is going to present with beaded edges in a pearly white appearing lesion. And where are the lesions present? Above the line joining the angle of the mouth and the tragus, the lesion will be present in the elderly population, and we can see rodent ulcer development, which is going to have rolled out edges, and if you do a biopsy, we are going to see the palisading appearance on histopathology. Condyloma acuminata is due to human papilloma viral infection. Remember dear students, condyloma lata is associated with secondary syphilis, acuminata is associated with human papilloma virus. It is a anogenital warts, and how does it manifest? It is going to manifest with a rough surface verrucous lesions present in the corneal sulcus, and also the lesions can be present over the gland sinus also. And the treatment in the pregnant woman is going to be with liquid nitrogen minus 196 degrees Celsius, called as cryotherapy. We can also use trichloroacetic acid also. And remember, in the normal individuals who are non-pregnant, we can use imiquimod and also podophyllin, but they are not used in pregnant women, so we replace the treatment with cryotherapy or TC application. And in this picture, you are able to see the papular lesions which are present in the coronal sulcus. These are called as pearly pineal papules. These are absolutely normal physiological lesions which are seen. These are not associated with human papilloma virus. Next, psoriatic arthritis. Remember dear students, methotrexate is going to be the drug of choice. Lichen planus, it is a Pavlovskomer's disorder which will present with so many P's. If you remember, they are going to be per papular lesions, plaques, which are pruritic, which are present in the plexar surfaces, which are plain topped, polygonal, purple colored, and we can also see the presence of the reticulate white lacy Wickham stripe present on the skin, and also the genitals, mucosal lesions are also common. And one more thing, remember the hair involvement, that is a scalp involvement, is going to produce a scarring alopecia, which is irreversible hair loss, which is called as lichen planopilaris. Pellagra, remember, very important, associated with B3 deficiency, niacin deficiency. It is associated with alcoholic individuals who are having the staple food as corn or maize, and it is associated with 4Ds, dermatitis, photodermatitis, producing Cassis necklace, which is a pigmented scaly rash present over the photo-exposed areas. The patients can also have diarrhea, there can be dementia, that is CNS involvement, and if not treated, the patient can also die. So, 4Ds. Tinea capitis, remember, the patients are going to have the loss of the scalp hair. In the children, it is going to be commonly seen. If the hair loss is permanent, it is scarring alopecia. Examples are chirion and favors. The boggy swelling here is pointing towards the diagnosis of chirion. And here you are able to see small black dots. This is black dot tinea capitis. And here you are able to see the gray colored patch. This is gray patch tinea capitis. In the hair, remember, alopecia areata is going to produce patches of the hair loss, which are complete loss of the hair due to the autoimmunity against anagen hair follicles, which is going to produce a swarmobius appearance on histopathology, and the treatment is going to be with intralesional steroids. In the secondary syphilis, remember, there is going to be moth-eaten alopecia produced over the scalp. Coming to the genital ulcer disease, sexual transmitted disorder, painful genital ulcer with painful inguinal bulbar points towards the diagnosis of chancroid, which is produced by Haemophilus ducreyi. Painless beefy red genital ulcer without any inguinal lymphadenopathy, that is pseudo bulbar, is classically seen in donovanosis, which is also called as granuloma inguinal. So to quickly see what are all the important points related to STDs, I will just vanish myself for some time. So if the patient is having a genital ulcer, and if it is multiple painful genital ulcers, and there is a presence of the painful inguinal lymphadenopathy, especially if there is suppuration in the inguinal lymphadenopathy, we call it as a bubo, and here the diagnosis will be chancroid. And if there is a patient who is having bilateral inguinal lymphadenopathy but without a bubo, then you should think of the diagnosis herpes genitalis. Now coming to the left hand side, you are able to see that there is a single painless genital ulcer, and associated with that there is no inguinal lymphadenopathy, we can call it as a pseudo bubo. Here the answer is going to be granuloma inguinal, also called as donovanosis. And here you can see painless inguinal lymphadenopathy, painless genital ulcer, the diagnosis you need to think is treponema pallidum associated heart chancre syphilis. Here in the middle you are able to see painful bubo is present in a patient who is having painless genital ulcer. Here you need to think of the diagnosis lymphogranuloma venereum produced by chlamydia trachomatis L1, L2, L3. So these are all the important points. I hope all the points are known to you already, and this is a revision. So please do that like button if this video was helpful. Share this among your friends so that they are also going to pass this examination, and you are all going to come to the cerebral hum event, which happens every time in the examination, post examination, as a part of celebration in Delhi. So thank you so much, and in the comments write down winner if you feel that you are going to be a successful winner in this examination. Do subscribe for more such awesome videos on a regular basis. Thank you so much. Happy learning. Sarvam Sri Krishna Param Sarve Jana Sukhina Bhavantu.